Welcome to episode number 86, and we are on scene with Trina and Diamond Doll. I'm shooting behind the scenes today, but they're setting up for the next scene. We already did the first scene, and it's a car scene. Vlog, this is the place where I document my journey through the music industry and where I document myself being a songwriter and filmmaker. So shout out to BB Lewis. He has been helping me, giving me opportunities for myself to grow, and that's a beautiful thing. And with this project, he said let's shoot some BTS behind the scenes for this video project for Diamond Doll. And it went well. I met some of South Florida's best music producers and directors, Dre Films, and it was such a beautiful thing. Shout out to Yin too. Yin, I've been working alongside with Abibi. We've been working collectively for the last couple months, and Yin produced the track. I'm so excited for him. He's getting the opportunities. I just want to send a shout out to him. But anyways, this experience, I wanted to give my feedback. I wanted to give my feedback because it might help some of you, especially some of you who are new to the game and want to network. And here are tips that I have for you. So number one is the environment. Whether you're going for a job, whether you're collaborating, or whether you're interning, you have to make sure you are in an environment that you can learn and give value, but also there's some reciprocation. People are giving value back to you. You know, you always hear about interns or people going to work at certain companies, whether it's in radio, whether it's a major record label, where they give all this value and they don't get anything in return. When I work at Circle House, I get lots of value. I work a lot, but I get so many opportunities. And that's something that I want everybody out there to realize. You need to be in where you are also getting something in return for the things that you work on. So please be sure, if you're interning, if you're working, if you're collaborating, make sure you're in a position to learn, to network, and get the opportunities to where you can grow, but also you're getting something in return. And my tip number two is to have a skill. When you go into situations where you're either collaborating or even working or even interning, you need to develop a skill or have skill sets. Because what I just learned is that if you don't have anything to give and you just want to give, you will stagnate. So when I go into a Circle House or go into a professional setting in the music industry, there's so many people who want to hire me because I can create content and I can produce video. When you go out there, please make sure that you're honing on your skills, or at least you find that one skill, something that you're good at, that nobody else can do, or something that where it's high in demand, and then you can tweak it, and where you can market yourself and have value and bringing money. Because at the end of the day, skills bring money. My main goal to my audience is to go out there and make sure you have a skill. I want you to go far. I want you to be the best that you can be. To be the best in your area. Whether it's publishing, whether it's marketing, whether it's video editing, you need to be the best. That's what I want my audience to be. So if you are on that same wavelength, make sure you have a skill or skill set that you can give to the people who you're working with or working for.